Hi, and welcome to our open stop-motion film project. Yesterday we were painting these and even the day before, so I'll go over to the other table and keep on painting these trees we're gonna need to for the film. So, and they have to have more than one color so that they more look like trees. So I will go over there and take my mic with me. And I will turn the light a little so it's easier to see, and then I will take a mouse with me. Turn the screen. And now I can see the video mixer. Also, I have painted some of them, as you can see, but we will and we don't have to cover it all. It's okay. That's the other color I'm looking through. But of course not the neon green. Neon green print. I need a lot of trees for those who haven't watched before. I need a lot of trees for the wood where the, or the forest where the story is going on. And these trees I'm painting here are only kind of fill trees. As you see, show you trees like this one is more have more character, so that and those I cannot make many of, because you will, if you repeat those through the forest, then you will recognize it and the illusion will get kind of destroyed. But if you, these one, that don't have that much character, you will not be able to recognize in that way. They will more or less look like this one when they are finished, with leaves on and so on. Whoopsie, be careful. You have to have 3D eyes when you're moving around with this. And this is the second layer of paint, as you can see. And we will give them one more, and then maybe we will kind of retouch them a little after the last paint. So that they look kind of natural. stig. I guess everyone is relaxed today because it's Friday and the weekend is coming up. Time for a little family fun. Quality time. On the job. Whoop! Yes! Not good. I have a very little foot to stand on, but when when I finish with them like this, then I put them in a box so I don't destroy them before I have to use them. They break very easily. In the print. Because that the extruder on the 3D printer was kind of burned out when I made these ones. I have gotten a new one, but the layer don't stick that well together. And then I have been a little cheapskate in the use of material because it's pretty much hollow inside the print. So I just tried that, but that was not a good idea. So they got even more fragile than they were to start with. But I have used a lot of plastic over the last year. So so sometimes you try to be a little economic, and then it comes to bite you. So. That's how it goes. And I have some more of these, but as I told yesterday, I'm got to a point where I need to get a hold of all the loose ends, so I know how much I have and how much more I need and so on. The first time you, in the start you just print because you know you need a lot of trees to make a forest. So. And then you kind of try to shoot how many, estimate how many you need. But that's kind of hard just to do in your head. Always just will be a guess. And then we have to make leaves to all of them. And that will be a big job as well. For those who don't know, the film will be about a young boy and his friend, and the young boy, the main character, his name is Flint, and he is a boy living in the Stone Age. Okay. And they are living in the forest. And sometime I wish that I have written a story about a lizard in the desert instead. Had to buy a lot of sand and threw on the table. But I have never been easy. I have never been good at making it easy for myself. So. So now I'm stuck in it. Maybe it's because I always have loved the forest and spent nearly my whole childhood in the forest. Every time my friends and we were finished with school, then we took our bikes to the forest. Maybe that has something to do with it. I don't know. Maybe because that I'm grown up in a home where there were tons of rooms and nasty stuff, so and in the school the teacher's hand sat very loose too, so. In the forest we were on our own and no grown-up interference. That's can also be a part of it. In that way, if you don't have it, good. If you don't have a what shall we call it? If you don't like to be at home, then you find some other space, other place where you can live your life with your friends, then you enjoy that a lot. There can be a lot of reasons. Now it is what it is, and I will finish it, whatever it takes. We will not have any green plastic shining through at all. That's not an option. one more cooked. Yeah, I'm moving around with the tablecloth, I think. Kick the tripod. Don't. And the last one of this round. I will get a plastic bag for this one. So we can, so it don't dry up before we have to use it next time, and that will take a little time before that happens, because the next color that we have to put on is not gonna be this one. So I will wash my hands. And then we will move over here again. Because we will let those sit and dry for a while. Sorry about this moving around, but there is no other way to do it in this very limited space that I always complain over. complain about, I think is the right word. I'll get some more. Room for them. I forgot to paint this one. And this. Someone needs a top of a branch somewhere, but we will see that. I don't know, we will see. And we'll use a flamethrower. Maybe not that dramatic, but I called it a flamethrower. Oops. So, we can do this away, and we can throw this away, and just keeping an eye on things, and then we can do this, so we can see if anybody say anything. You can see this one. You see, long bearded stuff, so we have to, but the easiest way, I will use a knife also, but these are very difficult to get back, get away with a knife, get rid of with a knife. So, but this here takes them at once. So, and there will be a bearded one over here too. You can see. And now I can scrape them with a knife. And that was why when the extruder on the printer was bad. Oops, don't do it on your fingers. This one. Because they are so thin that the knife don't get them. Even a scalpel don't get them. So, do I have all of them? More or less. Clean shaving. But don't do it on your legs. That will be the wrong thing to do. I think even waxing will be better. Even they say that's painful too. Now we can, if I did like this, because those thin threads You cannot take them. I have tried with a knife, but that didn't work. So now we burn them. Then I sand them with the machine afterwards, so that they get nice and clean, or as nice as clean as they can be. It's faster to take the worst part with this. And what I do with these is to cut them and set this one on top on this one with a stick between, and then they look exactly like the other ones. And I vary the length of the stick on all of them, so they get a little different height. But you can hear it's really tough when it's printed okay. But those places where it's not, that breaks very easy. So one has to be careful when you do this. And then you maybe think it's a cheap plastic this guy are using. If other 3D printing people out there, but no, this cost. This is the most expensive kind. So. I also thought that was the quality of the plastic. I did this, no, it wasn't. have to use my scalpel if I can find it. I found it. This one is very clumsy. This one is not. Couldn't live without a scalpel. That is a very important tool in my book. I know the blade are expensive, but they are really good. Put the machinery on. Keep your finger up. Okay. This one one go together. And this one goes together. Then that one was off pretty quick. Take with the sender. This one we cut. One later. This one we have done it with. This is a little thicker plate in the bottom. So. when we do this. In the meantime, the paint on the tree is dried up, and we can give them the last touch or layer of paint, and then maybe we should use an axe. That must be the normal tool you use on trees. This one is very nice for some reason. The reason I print with such a big footprint here, plate on the, it's to, so I'm sure it stays on the hotbed on the printer. If the only thing that was attached to the printer was this little spot, then it will break off when just a little thing got in the way, then it will break. And you have to do it all over again, because you can never replace it on the bed. That's impossible. So. And that have happened to me many times. Oops, many of these print takes many hours to make, so it's really frustrating when they an hour or two before they are finished they break off, and you have to put them in the garbage can. How it is. This is pretty fine too. Now these are ready for sanding, and I have done this little one. Thank you. Well, I will get a box to have them in. Sanded. Oops, and we have to glue that one. I can feel. And this will become 16 more trees. can we get that far? Oop. We have to save these. And then we have a trash can. Oops. If I could hit it. The hit rate was not impressive, but so. And we will go over here because it is dry. Take the mic with us. So, one more mic would be nice too. But I have this one and the one in the workshop, but there is so much we want to have. Now we will find some. Is this the right one? These colors are so close to each other that they are hard to see which one is the right one. Now we will see how they look. It's too. kind of covering too much, I think. Maybe put some more water in it. Let me try. See if we can get it right. We get a little stained look. Look here before we carry on. See if we get what we want. Thank you. think that's what we are going for. Thank you. trying to hit it the first time so I don't. I hit it, but that was the floor. Become I am. And I did not swear. Even then I was tempted. I think I will put a little more white in it. I hope to avoid to go through them all one more time. No, that's some time not possible. On the next one.
Uh
the local bell tower rings 10 o'clock, I think. I don't know if that is copyrighted. When the bell tower plays. I will tell you if they come after me. But that would be kind of fun, wouldn't it? The next will then be they will come after me for hearing it. We live in a strange world. With strange rules. If we can put it over without put it on the floor. I don't like ending up on the floor. We will fix it. But we don't want too many of those. We have to fix afterwards. We never get done if we always have to make something to them later. That's not progress. Let's see, opposite. And don't tilt or fall on the floor. Thank you. You just have to threaten them. Don't. I want some new coffee in this. That was good. They are really sticky. I'm afraid I have to give them one more time. That will be tomorrow evening. When I'm finished at the family. I don't know. See them in daylight. That's the best thing. There's a lot of water in it, so it dries up very slowly. So it's a little difficult to see how it will turn out. we have to give it one more time, then we do. Whatever it takes to get where we want. Because there are so many steps to making a film like this, and if you every time you you jump the fence, then you end up with something really bad. You have to do your absolutely best in every step of the way. And you can as well, because you are gonna regret it like crazy when to reach the end. And you sit and look at it and think, oh, that's not good, and oh, that's not good, and oh, because there will be play. There will be something. Or you want it or not, that you are not perfectly happy with. So, and not for the competition, but for your own part. Will regret it if you cut corners. It will stare you in the eye all the time. You think, I wish I didn't have done that. Or I wish I would have gone the extra length.
Cool.
One stained a tree. Just a moment. So, I kind of think they are looking good. But we have to do something with those we did yesterday, because they are too... kind of too painted. We will do that later. We will not have more accident. If we can avoid it. Next living picture. Best I grab both hands so I don't tilt them all. And one more. We don't want it to run down the side on it. No runners. Runners is not a good thing. that so I don't push it on the floor. Or down on the, a glass of water down on the computer underneath. Then the streaming will come to a abrupt end. I think go. Next one. Or maybe we should take some off there. On it goes. One unending circle. I think I will get a chair. It's a really long time to stand. For an old guy like me. One in here. That would be much better. Get the weight off your feet. Half a ton. Break them loose. This look is pretty good. Do not have to do any more of that. I think. And tomorrow maybe I think that looks ridiculous. Well, no. One have an opinion until you have a new one. So that's how it is. Often. One can also say one have an opinion until one get wiser, and then you have a new one. If I ever gonna make one more stop motion, it would also be in the woods, because now I have the trees, and so it will be Flint 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like Rocky 7 or whatever he came to. I guess that was because when he had spent money on the boxing glove, then it was best to get the most out of it. Something like that. Rocky Balboa. Is that one has gone all around all over the world. But nothing happened. Boop. So, up, and stand, freeze. It's gonna be a good day where we can start to put on the leaves on, because first then it starts to look like the forest. And we have to make two sets of leaves. Yeah. Fall and summer. So we can change them.
careful. No.
This one didn't stick to the cardboard. This one we have forgotten to. Put clay on. Have to do that later. Alligator. And then patch it up with some colors. Always something you forget. So But those from yesterday, we have to do something with. Because they don't look right. They look like plastic tree. And that we will not have. That's not an option. In my book, Oh, we have this one. I took two of the other tables, so I need to put the second color on that first, but I'll try to see if this make a difference on those from yesterday. We can make it a little more untidy. They are kind of way too nice. Need to look like a tree. So we'll try with one. See how that changes. If it changes at all, because these colors are very close. Don't matter that they have different nuances, but they have to kind of be in the same ballpark. We will see how it dries up. Stand it over here. see if there is any difference. We will see if there is. And now I'm going to take this one to this one. And some paper towel. So we can get that painted when it's dry. So, put it in the bag again. It kind of works, doesn't it? Or does it? It's hard to see yet. I think it does. Shall we dare and do it, Cup? Cup Warp. So we really can see. To have a little more. White. And then I will do a very little squeeze of this. Because this is really coming through the green one. Thank you. I see how that works. Just for the fun of it, go away. Let's see how that dries up. Why do that? We will see. Let it dry. But if it works, you will give them something of that tomorrow. One never know if it does. Yeah. And the mic over here. Be careful not to take anything down. If I can. That went without any drama. I guess that was a good thing. This camera, oops. And move all our stuff over on this side of the water. That's house. Those look I think the light is a little better over here. I don't think the one we did before will work, but those we made today will. You can see they are kind of a little spotted, but it's hard to see now because the light are reflecting. But as soon as they get some matte lacquer, you will be able to see it. And then we have to do the other ones, and I have to glue the top and glue a stick in between those we we use the scissors for. But we will not start anything more tonight. And in 3 minutes, it's midnight. So I will thank you for the visit and hope you will look by another time. So thank you and good night.